Good evening and welcome to Shehernama Awaaz. BJP President Amit Shah told a Gujarat court today that he had seen Maya Kodnani, a leader of his party, in the state assembly and then at Ahmedabad Sola Civil Hospital on the morning of February 28, 2002. Mr. Shah appeared as a defense witness in a riot case in which Kodnani is accused of murdering 11 Muslims on that day in Naroda Gam, an Ahmedabad suburb. Ms. Kodnani, who is a gynecologist and was a legislator at that time, has pleaded in court that she was not in Naroda Gam when the rioting happened. She has claimed that she was in the state assembly that day and then went straight to the Sola Civil Hospital where Amit Shah was present. She had sought that Mr. Shah, who was a Gujarati legislator too, then testify to help prove her alibi. Maya Kodnani was inside the state assembly at 8:30 a.m., Mr. Shah told the court today, adding that he had then left the assembly and reached the hospital at about 9:30 or 9:45 a.m. He said he met Kodnani while leaving the hospital between 11 and 11:15 a.m. and that they were escorted out together, after which they went their separate ways. Asked by lawyers whether he knew where Maya Kodnani was between the time that he saw her at the assembly and in the hospital, Mr. Shah said he did not know. He also said he did not know where she went from the hospital. Witnesses have alleged in court that Maya Kodnani led the rioters who attacked Naroda Gam on February 28, 2002. They have said they saw her in area between 9:30 and 10 a.m. on that day. Home Minister Rajnath Singh said today that anti-national elements have been trying to foment tension in the society by posting unverified information on social media and asked people not to forward such messages without verification. Mr. Singh said information in news that was completely wrong or having no basis was being regularly circulated on social media, such as WhatsApp, and many people consider it to be true. I want to tell SSB Jawans not to believe such messages and forward to anyone without verification, as anti-national elements have been trying to foment trouble in the society. We all have to be very careful before believing or forwarding them, he said after launching the intelligence wing of the Sashastra Seema Bal in Delhi. Praising the role of the SSB, which guards the 1751-kilometer-long Indo-Nepal and the 699-kilometer-long Indo-Bhutan borders, Mr. Singh said it is very tough to guard such open borders, which allow visa-free movements of people, than fence borders with Pakistan and Bangladesh. International news. With a crackdown on dissenters and a charm offensive to woo the kingdom's swelling youth population, Saudi Arabia's king-in-waiting Mohammed bin Salman is cementing his grip on power, analysis say today. The 32-year-old crown prince, often known as MBS, is said to be the first millennial to occupy the throne in a country where half the population is under 25, though the timing of his ascension remains unknown. Already viewed as the de facto ruler controlling all the major levers of government from defense to economy, MBS is seen as stamping out traces of internal dissent before any formal transfer of power from his 81-year-old father, King Salman. Authorities last week arrested around 2 dozen people, including influential clerics, in what activists decried as coordinated crackdown. Analysts say many of those detained and resistance to MBS's aggressive foreign policy that includes a boycott of Persian Gulf neighbor Qatar, as well as of some of his bold reforms, including privatizing state assets and cutting subsidies. Saudi officials have instead suggested a foreign plot to overthrow the government without disclosing details. In recent years, we cannot recall a week in which so many prominent Saudi Arabian figures have been targeted in such a short span of time, said Sama Hadi, the director at Amnesty International. Bollywood news. Sajid Nadiadwala's Baghi 2 has kickstarted shoot in Pune. The second installment to the 2016 Baghi will be shot in college campus of Pune. One of the biggest action films of the year, Baghi 2 will feature Tiger Shroff and Disha Patnani in lead roles. The action film is all set to raise new standards in terms of action. Baghi 2 will release 2 years after the first film Baghi released. While Baghi released on 29th April 2016, Baghi 2 will release on 27th April 2018, exactly 2 years after the first film hit the screens. The Sajid Nadiadwala film will bring in action sequences never seen before in Bollywood. The filmmaker has managed to bring together one of the most anticipated pairings in Bollywood. There has been huge excitement to witness the chemistry between Tiger Shroff and Disha Patani on the screen. Thank you, that was all. Have a nice evening.